Michel Moore has not produced a documentary. He's produced a cartoon.
Michel Moore is dead wrong. Their health care is terrible in London. It's terrible in Canada.
The film is filled with content Canadians and Brits sitting in waiting rooms. But you won't find medical utopia elsewhere.
Michel Moore is a pathetic propagandist. He's not even any good at it. Putting that aside here.
Well, I knew they couldn't handle it. France does seem a bit too good to be true. But what you don't know is that when I was making this movie, I went somewhere else. I visited a place that blows France right out of the water. A place so scary, I couldn't put it in this film. It's a place where the standard of living is one of the highest in the world. France and England only give you 6 months paid maternity leave. This place gives you a full year. This country will buy you a new car if you're having trouble using public transportation. And the country's health insurance will pay for a 2-week tropical vacation to help you with your ailments through the long winters. Is this some distant, faraway planet? No, it's Norway. Norway is first on the United Nations Human Development List, meaning that they're ranked number one for things like literacy, education, health care, and per capita income. They rank number two in the world for having women in government, with Sweden at number one. By the way, the United States ranks number 66.
Det viktigste at alle i Norge, uansett om du rik eller fattig, uansett om du kvinne eller mann, og uansett hvor du bor I landet.
We don't want to have death penalty as part of Norwegian legislation. There is no life sentence. We haven't, in principle, no armed police either. Most policemen walking in the streets will not be carrying a gun.
Whoa, wait, was that a poodle?
What we call conservative in Norway, I suppose you would, most people in the United States would call liberal.
And they're ahead of the rest of the world when it comes to renewable energy. They discovered a way to tap into the warm glow from raw sewage in order to heat their homes.
The biggest sewage day is in the weekend. People is out partying and they go to the toilet, drink a lot of beer, again go to the toilet, and we get a lot of sewage in our system.
That's right. The Norwegians only drink because they want to save the planet. In fact, they love the earth so much they wouldn't dream of letting a private company own all their oil reserves. An island that's a model of sustainable ecology. A destination for families on the weekend. A popular spot for locals to experience a close-knit community of murderers, rapists, and child molesters.
Okay, this is Håvold and Ronny, the two guys that's living here. They will talk with you, tell you about how it is to stay here.
Meet Håvold Sjørven, an official for UNICEF, who had a better idea of where the children's money should be spent. And Ronny Mierstadt. His looks could kill, but his hands did instead.
And those guys can walk around with you afterwards.
Okay.
Maybe we can have a cup of coffee or something.
Perfect.
Every activities we have on the island should be an activity that will bring you to learn responsibility. If I pick up the potatoes every autumn, and we try to get every prisoners and every staff member to do it together. If we do that together, we are doing something that shows the prisoners that we are equal human beings.
Every guy you will see out here are prisoners. Those who are working here will wear a uniform. They live 4, 5, 6 people together. They have to wake themselves up in the morning, make their own breakfast and go to work, just like you and me.
Tyve? Nah. It tells me it's 20 degrees in the water. I think it's 15. They told you. You know they're prisoners.
I'm working outside with ordinary people. I go down and take the ferry out of the island and go to the shore and travel to work. I'm only here on the weekends and the nights. So that's good.
I tried to get a job on this ferry right away. We got a good opportunity to smuggle and run away and so.
Did you ever think about doing that?
No.
I feel I have managed to calm down because I used to work 20 hours a day. I used to travel 300 days a year. I'm sure I'll live 10 years longer because I'm here.
Yeah, it looks like paradise, but when you're staying here, it's everything sounds so easy and you can go out and you can do this and do this, but you always know that it's a prison.
We had a prisoner here. He was convicted for murder. He cut two people up with a chainsaw. And most people will think that this kind of person cannot be in this kind of prison. He have to be locked up. But he came to this prison on the last time of his sentence, and he served here for 4 years. And he worked in the forest with a chainsaw.
You have dinner parties? I have had a tie and a jacket on a couple of times, but that's on special occasion.
Maybe the way to rehabilitate prisoners is to send them to dinner parties or have them work on their tan.
If you treat people properly, they may change behavior and be good, ordinary citizens.
Yes, these people are crazy.